This is durian. The name comes from the Malaysian word thorn, which checks out. The fruit is native to Southeast Asia, and Thailand grows more than 500,000 metric tons of these weird-looking things every year. And as you might know, it has an odor. A strong one. And we're gonna tell you why. Despite its smell, many people really love the stuff. In Southeast Asia, they even call durian the king of fruits. Alfred Russel Wallace had this to say about durian.
A rich custard, highly flavored with almonds, gives the best general idea of it. But there are occasional wafts of flavor that call to mind cream cheese, onion sauce, sherry wine, and other incongruous dishes. There's a rich, glutinous smoothness in the pulp which nothing else possesses, but which adds to its delicacy.
But that smell! It may be a beloved treat in Southeast Asia, but that smell is strong, to say the least. It's so strong that some hotels, subways, and movie theaters ban it. And we thought cell phones were a problem. So what does it actually smell like? Well, we got some of our friends at PBS to give it a whiff while we're at VidCon.
I was guessing hot garbage, and I am met with hot garbage here.
So I remember it smelling worse. I've been in markets in Asia where they've had it, and it actually doesn't smell as bad as what I thought it did. It's kind of fine.
It smells like food garbage that's been sitting for a couple days.
Yeah, it's, you know, I thought I would hate it more, actually.
So why does it smell so pungent? Chemists have identified about 45 different molecules that make up durian's odor. They cover an impressive variety of smells: honey, roasted onion, caramel, skunk, and rotten egg, to name a few. Incredibly, a recent study narrowed those down to just two molecules the researchers say can mimic the fruit's overall smell. A whole bunch of compounds on that list have sulfur atoms in them, some of which can smell pretty bad. You know that special stink of rotten eggs? Yeah, that's hydrogen sulfide. Humans are insanely good at smelling sulfur-containing molecules. Your nose is 100 million times more sensitive to ethane thiol than ethanol. And there's probably a good evolutionary reason for that too. Rotten food, dead animals, poisonous gases, and even the sweat of some carnivorous predators all have sulfur-containing compounds, so it makes sense natural selection made us especially sensitive to them. Our noses are so good at sniffing out sulfur thanks to what happens between sulfur compounds and copper ions in our smell receptors. When scientists blocked copper from the noses of lab mice, they couldn't tell the difference between the gross-smelling methyl thiomethane thiol from the more pleasant eugenol, which shows up in cinnamon and basil. Sulfur helps to explain why durian smells so bad to some people, but why do people put up with the smell? Sometimes we can forgive a little stinkiness if the food tastes really, really good, so how does it taste?
The fruity stuff reminds me a little bit of maybe kiwi fruit or something like that.
It's like a mushy pear or something like that.
If you took an apple and you dipped it in a landfill, and then covered it in yogurt, that is durian.
Frankly, I don't hate it.
I don't hate it from all. Can't stop, won't stop.
You know, it could be an acquired taste. I hated coffee and chocolate for a really long time.
I don't think it deserves a bad rap. It's fine. I mean, it's just a fruit. Why are we picking on fruit?
All right, we hear you. But to switch it up, we asked professional chef Parnell Sivan, who cooks with durian and was raised eating it, what he thought it tastes like.
It's hard to describe because it tastes sweet, it tastes custardy, and it has like a funkiness that, like a fermentation type of funkiness that other fruits don't have, and is just distinguished from other fruits, and that one just sings to me so much.
So durian is clearly an acquired taste, but why could some people get over that funkiness while others just couldn't? Not everyone smells or tastes things the same way. Our DNA has code for roughly 800 odor receptors, though scientists think only about 400 of those actually function. Genetic variations in these receptors can change the way they function and alter your perception of an odor, so you might not smell durian the same way Joe did. And then there are people who can't smell at all. Seriously. Maybe that sounds great at first, but most of what we call flavor isn't really taste, it's smell. Joe just might be missing out on the true complexity of this exotic delicacy. Plus, the way we react to smells is determined in part by our experiences. Odors can stir up memories and emotions in people. So if you grew up eating durian, it might trigger fondness rather than revulsion. Some cheeses stink to the high heavens, but people still love them some stinky cheese. Or maybe we here in America just aren't getting good durian.
There are echelons of durian. There's some durians that are highly prized where it's, the seeds are small, the meat is large, and there's some that are like good for transporting. And those aren't always as good.
Parnas told us that he thinks durian gets a bad rap in the United States because, well, we're just not getting very high quality durian. And that, my friends, is the science of a very odorous fruit. Have you ever had durian? What's your verdict on the king of fruits? Let us know in the comments. I personally think it tastes like an avocado and a mango had a baby and then fed that baby nothing but garlic. And in the words of Joey Tribbiani,
I like it.
Be sure to hit the thumbs up and subscribe before you head out to find one of these beauties for yourself. And hey, thanks for watching.